Well, you know, you wouldn't know it looking at Tommy, but he's has a lot in common with Christy and me about as far as a white trash background goes.
Hey.
It's true. Ask him.
You were raised a poor boy, on a blues farm.
Well,
mm-hmm.
I have a family of I would consider them epic in the way they live. It's amazing. I'll tell you a story if you don't mind.
Sure, go ahead.
I don't tell it to many people because it's kind of unbelievable. Mm-hmm. But so here's the story. I have an uncle who lived at the top of a mountain. Uh-huh. in I think it would be the
summit.
No,
the
Smoky Mountains.
Smoky Mountains.
So he lives an hour and a half from town, which is 3 hours from a city. So he's like literally very out there. He has no plumbing. Mm-hmm. And no running. He stole a porta potty to use as the bathroom.
Cool.
He stole a porta. So if you ever drive through Tennessee and you see a porta potty and they're chained to the concrete, and mm-hmm. you would be like, why would that? David Johnagin is why they chain them down.
Wow. Johnagin
They've
law.
Changed
okay.
policies.
Johnagin, porta potty theft law.
So he lives at the top of this mountain, and this is him. This isn't me. I apologize for what he did. So there's a small plane that crashed
right
above his house trailer. Mm-hmm.
Trailer.
Right.
Crashed, mm-hmm. right? So he's the first person
to the plane. Oh, my.
And the pilot is dead. Uh-huh. So he says. We have no witnesses.
Oh, my God.
But the pilot is not.
Well, if you hit a mountain, generally
yeah.
speaking,
you don't really yeah. do well. Mm-hmm.
But my uncle could have brought the plane down for all I know.
Yeah. Room for doubt with his yeah. uncle. Yeah.
So what happens is, my dad's telling me the story as we're driving to my uncle's, and my dad has maybe told the truth enough times that you believe him every once in a while.
Okay.
Generally lies.
Okay.
So he's telling me the story, and he goes, so your uncle comes up on the plane, the guy's dead, and he knows that the earliest, it's going to be an hour and a half before the cops get there.
Mm-hmm.
Which is never, when any time you even think how long it's going to take the cops to get somewhere, you're not in the right position. Like, that never comes up at a good time.
That's right.
So he takes the guy's belt, uh-huh. he takes his watch, he takes his wallet, and he takes his boots.
Oh,
my
God.
Uncle takes these things from this guy. My dad tells me this story, and I go, I can't believe you right now, right?
Right. Uh-huh.
He goes, well, when we get to your uncle's house, he'll take you up to the plane because they couldn't take the plane down. They had to secure it to the mountain because they didn't want it to slide down and hit people's houses. So we get to my uncle's house, and I say, my dad said you did this, and my dad was kind of seemed disgusted by it, and my uncle goes, yeah, I did it. I sold your dad the boots for $20, and he points at the boots, and my dad was wearing them as he told me the story.
Oh, my God.
He's like, how do you even sound disgusted? Did he overcharge you for dead boots?
Oh,
and the plane's still up there. My uncle, in the meantime, over the few months, has stripped the plane. Anything that's not chained why is exactly
firewood.
Right.
Uh-huh.
He has a plane propeller. I'm like, do you expect many planes to crash and eventually assemble your own out of those? And then the part that I told Chick that I thought was my favorite part was they thought it would be hilarious in the trailer to take the plane propeller and secure it to the ceiling and make people think that it's their ceiling fan as a joke, right?
Sure.
There's
and
more.
I think that they got to the joke part by going, I don't know how to put a motor in it. Uh-huh. I think they really wanted it to be.
Right.
So they put the ceiling fan in the ceiling.
Or the propeller.
They put the propeller. Yeah, I call it uh-huh. a ceiling fan.
Okay.
Uh-huh. Uh-huh. Yeah.
They put the propeller in the ceiling of the trailer, and it just rips the whole ceiling and falls on the kitchen table.
They're pretty heavy.
It's a
real
propeller,
are
and
heavy.
You live in a trailer. It's not meant There's no spot in a trailer that can have
a
paper
stud.
Wow.
Joist.
Normally,
aren't beam.
Very low ceilings in a trailer.
Yeah.
I mean,
so there's just big holes.
There's a giant hole.
Where they trying to attach the airplane.
You just see the tin roof of the trailer.
Oh,
Tommy Johnagin is our guest. And I guess you're from an unusual family then.
Yeah, that's my dad's side of the family.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay. Wow.